My dudes, what is happening, man? This is Trent, and this week I wanted to talk about something that's a little bit more technical, but it's for beginners to intermediate artists who might be struggling with drawing figures. And a lot of times people will say to me, well, I can barely draw a stick figure. And the irony of that statement is that if you can draw a stick figure, you're halfway to being able to draw a human, a character, because a stick figure, a lot of times what we do is we'll do something like this for a stick figure. My stick figures are bad, by the way. But like, let's say that this is, you know, your average person is going to draw a stick figure kind of like this, right? And the irony of it is that this is the foundation of every humanoid drawing, right? And what I mean by that is that we begin with understanding these basic primitives, these primitive ideas. Like we know that that's representing a leg, and this is representing an arm, and this is representing a head, right? But what's interesting is that by expanding on our knowledge of that foundation, we can then create a little bit more of a believable humanoid figure. So for instance, if we draw in the clavicle, and the hip bone, and maybe a few extra joints for where the knees would be, and the feet and the hand and the elbows. By adding a couple of more of these joints, we begin to express a slightly more complex and greater understanding of the humanoid figure. So only being able to draw a stick figure just means that it's something that you haven't yet developed and created the articulation enough to be able to express. So when somebody says that I can't draw anything more than a stick figure, it's quite literally to an artist, it's like, that's like somebody saying, I can't run. Well, can you walk? Well, that's just the beginning part. That's just the start of it. To give you an example, when I sit down to draw a character, oftentimes what I'll do is something that's similar to a stick figure. I just kind of create like a silhouette. It starts with a stick figure kind of playing out the movement or the positioning of the limbs. And then I add articulation through a silhouette. I add the elbows and the joints, and it's very primitive. I mean, I'm not going into every muscle right away or anything like that. And that might be beyond your skill level at this point. And it's okay, I think, if you want to just do sheets full of silhouettes of figures in different poses. I think that's actually a really great practice. And what you're gonna see me do in this video is essentially the different levels as I kind of add out another layer of articulation to our little figurine, we're going to eventually run into a wall where we're gonna need to pull up reference. And if you're already at that point and you're like, well, I don't know how many joints are in an elbow, I think maybe now is a good time to look up a photograph of an arm and try to break it down into those joints and twigs and sticks. So sticks connected by joints, basically. And from my stick figure, I build out the musculature to add in basic understanding of the larger muscles. I think that when you first start to dig into understanding anatomy, your basic understanding is usually just the big muscles that stand out. In the same way that when we're describing a vehicle, we might, you know, if I don't know much about vehicles, I might say, oh, the red sports car. But if you're a, you know, connoisseur or you're really interested in cars, you might be very specific and say, oh, that's an Audi TT. That's the Quattro edition from 2001, for example. Very specific because you've studied it. You've developed that skill and that understanding. Learning anatomy and learning to draw humanoids and characters is really the same thing. It's your understanding from your memory early on is going to be the big shapes, the chest muscles, the pecs, or the shoulder muscles because they're large, the biceps and the basic joints such as your elbow and wrist and things like that. As you begin to refine your skills, as you begin to refine where you are in your understanding of anatomy, the more specific you can get. And at some point you'll know when you run into a wall because you'll just want to fill it in as a blob. And that's when you're going to want to dig up some photo reference. Now, I'm just using a photo here of Arnold Schwarzenegger, one of the most famous bodybuilders, here as an example, and you might want to dig into anatomy books as well. The first thing I notice is the trapezius. Now, on my little sketch, my trapezius did not stick out enough. It was kind of weak, and also, you'll notice even on the photograph, I'm just sketching in, tracing out how the muscles are connecting so that I can build a connection, a neural connection in my mind. I'm building a model of what it is that I'm seeing. Like, what can I gather from this photograph of Arnold that I can apply to the anatomy of the character I'm drawing right now? And you might want to find poses of the characters in the poses that you're actually using. One of the other things I did was I made copies of his head so that I could figure out, oh, okay, so he's roughly 7 heads tall total. And I wanted to make sure that mine was pretty accurate to that, and he is. So it's a good measure of trying to figure out how wide the shoulders are, how tall he is from the tip of his head to the bottom of his toe. And this is really just how I do anatomy studies. I take photographs and then I trace out the defining edges of each of those muscles so that I can then incorporate them into my own drawings. I don't draw a lot of muscular guys or anything like that, so it's a good refresher for me to do something like this. And of course, the legs get really tricky. The toughest parts I found are the back muscles, the rib muscles and abdomen muscles, and leg muscles around the thighs. Really tough to kind of grasp a full understanding of if you don't start digging into anatomy books, and that's because they're seldom as defined as those big glamour muscles. But when you look at our lineup here, you can really see how that stick figure is really just the most primitive way of expressing the human limbs, the human body. And if you want to do all kinds of poses, start with stick figures and then build them out in the similar fashion, and then do the appropriate anatomical study from photographs to understand how the musculature works for the muscle in that particular pose. So for example, here, you know, if I wanted to flex up his muscles, I could use this as a really great reference, another one of Arnold, of course, but instead I'm pulling different information from this one. Specifically, I was looking up abs, and I was trying to figure out, like, how can I break down the abs into a more understandable way of thinking. So of course he has his lats that really, I mean, he's really had strong, defined, huge lats. And then these ab muscles that come in from the sides as well, really trying to pull the information from the photograph to better inform my understanding. I noticed specifically with the arms here, the shoulders, they connect, they don't just continue from that central point where it meets the bicep. They actually kind of form, there's a secondary muscle right there, and I don't know what it's called, that does connect it to the pectoral. And then I'm just refining the anatomy, leg understanding of the leg anatomy as I'm looking at the photograph from the reference and drawing out where the muscles connect. This is from a workout book, and muscle magazines are actually really helpful for getting better at this sort of a thing. Now, if you want to start painting like Braum or Frazetta, or you want to become like a master fantasy painter, it's going to be valuable for you to keep digging into that, into muscle magazines and anatomy, even far beyond that. But I wanted to just kind of give a basic coverage of how to develop this skill, how I go about the process of this. You can see how, I mean, it's hard to imagine poses. So sometimes I find a photograph of something awesome, like a really badass pose, or I still frame a scene from a movie, of a fight scene or something like that. And then I use that as a basis for my posing with the basic understanding that I've developed of anatomy over the years. And I try to modify it. And I'm really like, when I say using it as reference, you can notice that I'm not tracing it. I'm not making an exact copy of the pose. It's just giving me that idea of like how that sword could fit over the front of his head. And for example, with his shoulder crossing in front of his face, sometimes we get static, we get stuck in our view of like how we might go about doing a pose. And because we fall back on our routines, we fall back on safety, we fall back on the things that are comfortable. And by doing photo studies or photo reference in this manner, we're always pushing ourselves to have a greater understanding of the dimensionality of the objects that we're sketching and drawing. I actually, this video, the idea for this video came from this collection of really rough sketches that I had done. I was trying to do a cover for the Aikida game, and I was trying to come up with a concept for what that cover could look like. And so I had just time-lapse captured all of these sketches that I had done, and I thought it would be really valuable for you to see how I apply a lot of everything that I showed at the beginning of this video, you know, to figuring out poses for bodies. And you can see some really swooshy kind of action and how I kind of build out my anatomy from these really rough sketches of just bodies in motion. Sometimes I start with a hand that's really interesting, and you can see, I really like that one. I might really use this one for another shot, because it's very ninja-like, you know, for this Aikida character who's supposed to have a ninja feel. And then I wanted to do a shot of him just chilling on top of a mech, you know, and, you know, just different ideas, sketching them all out. And it's not a bad idea for you to just fill up whole sheets full of these kind of poses. When I was doing comic books, I would do this a lot. And then actually what's great about that is if you do a bunch of different action poses, when you finally get to drawing your comic book, you've already got a bunch of these poses worked out. You can drop them into your panels and use them as scenes in your comic. And especially if you're doing them from studies from various movies, or like John Wick is a really great one, or I like to watch old Kung Fu movies because a lot of the content that I draw in my illustrations is kind of Kung Fu related. So I'll pull up a lot of movies like Iron Monkey, you know, old school Kung Fu movies, or Seven Samurai still has some really great shots for like samurai type of characters, characters with swords and sword battles standing off. You know, there's some really interesting kind of poses that you could come up with from those resources and from those sources from films, and then apply them to your own characters. And you only use it as a rough guide. You end up taking it over. You know, every single one of these poses that you're seeing me sketch out comes from a stick figure. It's really just, that's the foundation, the bones of every pose, of every character drawing, is a stick figure. But a really great starting point, especially if you want to push to develop your understanding of anatomy a little bit more. Not any one piece is going to be, you know, perfectly final. Recognize and acknowledge that it's all a development curve. It's all on this process pipeline where the next one's going to be better, and then the one after that's going to be more refined. And like, my mechs aren't as good as I want them to be right now, so I'm going to be doing some studies of some engineering and some mechanical design, some real world robotics, to try to improve my robot designs. And that's my method of learning, really, and my method of developing a skill. So don't beat yourself up for wherever you are on that spectrum. If you're only at that stage 3 of drawing stick figures, you know, where you're just starting to add silhouettes and posing out your figures, that's okay. Just pick up some photo reference and develop that skill. And every day that you're investing in your skill level, you're getting one step closer to being able to do that without the reference. And that's when you start to get, that's what I call playtime. That's where you start to get creative with it and start to make your own thing and add your own voice to it. And then before you know it, someday people are looking at you and going, how the hell do you get so good at doing all these poses and things? And you're just like, I don't know, man. I just do it. I do that. Well, if you're watching this and you like my artwork and you'd like to dissect more of my process, which I do get people asking me about all the time, I of course have all that available, as well as some brushes and easy art lessons, as well as some advanced AAA environment concept art workshops over on my Gumroad channel. It's certainly a pleasure when you stop by. It's a little awkward when you don't, of course. So please remember to leave a comment if you have any questions or anything you'd like to know about doing art in the comment section below. And until next time, I'll catch y'all. Mañana, bon, and ciao, baby. Oh, yeah.